Hey Eagle Nation, I'm Pearson Davenport, the Eagle Nation News Technology Correspondent, and you're watching Sync in Progress for Wednesday, September 25th.
Good morning, Prosper High School. I'm Aaron Mraz, and these are your daily announcements. I'd like to share with you something that I learned this morning. I learned that giraffes have antennas, and that they use these antennas to drink water. I never knew. Now on to the announcements. Harry Potter. Looking for Alaska, Catcher in the Rye. Every year, there are hundreds of attempts to remove books from the shelves of bookstores, libraries, and schools. Don't close the book on your freedom to read by reading your favorite banned book during the Banned Books Week. Stop by the library and check out one today. If you are interested in competing in UIL academics or you'd like more information about the program, please join us for an ice cream social in the cafeteria. This is a come-and-go event from 4:30 to 6. UIL has added a film festival to the academic contest this year. Any student in good standing at PHS is eligible to submit a script for one of the three categories: narrative, animation, or documentary. You do not need to be in theater or audio video productions to submit. You just need a great idea and a desire to succeed. See Ms. Mueller in the upstairs principal's office for more details. Hurry, the deadline for picking up a submission form is October 4th. There will be a parent information meeting for all students interested in trying out for the bowling team tomorrow at 6:30 in the LGI room. For more information, see Ms. Gramley in room 1151. Today is the last day that freshmen and juniors can register for the PSAT test. To register, see Ms. Benavides in the counseling office. The cost of the test is $20. There will be an Interact Club meeting today after school at 4. All Interact Club members are reminded to wear their shirts. For this week's Blackout Pep Rally, everyone must bring white knee-high socks or white gloves to do the Prosper Rumble in the dark. Wear a dark t-shirt so that the gloves and or socks can be seen. And now, back to you, Pearson.
In the coming months, two new gaming consoles are set to change the gaming world, the Xbox One and the PlayStation 4. Here to talk about these two new consoles and what users can expect is correspondent Aaron Mraz. Aaron, it's good to see you.
You too.
So I'm gonna start by asking you a couple questions about both the consoles and some like stuff about their specs and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So what has Microsoft done to improve the Xbox One in recent months?
Xbox has taken in a lot of input, both good and bad. And they've decided to change the console to where it will now accept used games. It was before that used games were not accepted at all. Now it accepts most all of them. Also, the Xbox One will work without the Kinect. And internet connection will not be required for offline games.
So has Sony done anything to the PlayStation in response to the changes to the used games policy and the internet policy on the Xbox One?
No. Yes. Sony will not change the PlayStation in any way, but it will try to get more exclusive deals with games.
So is that going to be one of the determining factors for users as to which console they will buy, such as games and stuff like that?
Yeah, games will most likely be the determining factor for this. Microsoft has already gotten some great deals with games like Rise, Son of Rome, Halo 5, of course, and all sorts of other games.
Yeah, because Halo has always been a big determining factor for Xbox. It's always been a big seller. So who, in your opinion, is winning the gaming console battles?
To be honest, right now it's a pretty level playing field since the Xbox One is updated a lot. It'll probably be up to the preference of the people.
Yeah, especially stuff like games, stuff like that. It's going to be really a matter of what games you like more, whether you like games like COD or whether you like Halo and stuff like that. But thanks, Aaron. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
I know I'm going to be very excited this winter when these two consoles are released. Today, popular media such as movies and music affect students more than ever. Here today with our new segment that talks about the ways that popular media affects students is Malaysia White with her segment, Culture Club.
Thanks, Pearson. Today's focus is on how gaming impacts our culture that relies on technology and its effects on everyday users, specifically Humble Bundle. I personally call it the bundle. I discovered the website looking for ways to help with charity and found several interesting things that I think you would enjoy. The Humble Bundle is a charity that provides donators a set of 5+ games that can be downloaded and played on their computer either through Steam or Origin. Humble Bundle has numerous popular games such as Battlefield 3 and Dead Space. Such games have been previously featured on the bundle, which changes up every 2 weeks. And what's amazing about this is almost all of the proceeds go directly to charities that provide entertainment to terminally ill children for no charge. So let's show our support to Humble Bundle. With Eagle Nation News, I'm Malaysia White.
Thanks, Malaysia. In this fast-moving world where technology improves itself every day, news needs to be quick. That's why it's time for the first edition of Quick Minute News. All of you gamers out there will remember the Smash 2011 DC game, Batman Arkham City, that was released to rant reviews. Well, this year, DC is set to release a prequel to Arkham City, Arkham Origins. In this game, Batman is only in his second year of crime fighting and is still young in his career. The game also boasts a new multiplayer mode where gamers can face off in a gang fight manner. Arkham Origins is set to be released on October 25th, setting it up to be a popular game for holiday. Today, Samsung also released its first smartwatch, the Galaxy Gear. The smartwatch will be $300 and will sport functions such as music control and stuff like that. It will connect to any current Samsung Galaxy device through Bluetooth. With this, it can then change music and even do calls with its large list of functions, making it a very large competitor to the rumored Apple iWatch. Also, in the coming days, Samsung is set to release its new version of the Note 10.1 with an octa-core processor and 3 GB of RAM, setting it up to improve upon its 2013 precedents. And that was Quick Minute News. Now with the special announcement is Mr. Wright.
The second annual Homecoming Talent Show will be Friday, October the 18th at 9:30 a.m. in the arena. The entire student body and Prosper community can attend. We will have student and teacher judges. We will give away very nice trophies to winners for first, second, and third place. All winners and participants will get your picture in the yearbook. The talent show competition is only open to our students in grades 9 through 12 that attend Prosper High School. If you're interested in participating, you will need to sign up during your lunchtime in the cafeteria beginning today. When you sign up, we'll need to know all the names of each performer in your group, what your talent is, and what equipment that you will need. For example, if you are a stage band member, we will need to know the equipment you will bring, what sound equipment you will need us to provide, and how many mics for multiple seniors you will need as well. Examples of talent performed in years past include singing, dancing, including belly dancing, gymnastics, musical instruments, comedy acts, and many, many more. All acts must be school appropriate, including all lyrics and dance moves. Everyone who signs up will have to attend a mandatory audition on Wednesday, October the 9th in the arena. You will audition in front of a talent show committee in order to be fair for everyone. Last year, the talent show was a huge success. I know we have some very talented students at Prosper High School. Again this year, we will have a huge production and we'll make this a first-class event for the entire student body as part of our homecoming tradition. The last day to sign up for the talent show is next Wednesday, October the 2nd. Let's make this a day to remember as we celebrate Homecoming 2013.
Once again, I'm Pearson Davenport, and remember, live long and prosper.